Because who does not love me? I don't know. I'm also kind of a chinchilla. I'm cute and cuddly. Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44, from the Netherlands, hence the accent. I love to play with makeup, colorful, neutral. It doesn't really matter as long as it's cruelty free. I also have a sarcastic sense of humor and apparently I'm kind of weird. If you think you can vibe with that, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button because I upload regularly. I want to say a lot, but I thought let's kind of spruce it up again, you know? Today I am going to play with a brand that I have never played with before. I have known about this brand for quite some time and they are known for their loose pigments, especially multi-chromy, shimmery goodness. And recently she has started doing pressed eyeshadows. And I am talking about Sigil Me, or Sigil Inspired by Tammy Tanuka. It's a Russian-based brand, if you don't know that. It is, I don't know, if you love multi-chromes and loose pigments, I think you kind of know the brand. Or at least that's how I found them through Angelica Nykvist. I will link her channel down below. But she has recently started doing pressed eyeshadows. And I think it was last month. She released kind of a neutrally palette, which is gorgeous. But I thought, yeah, I have that. It wasn't really the thing that I wanted to try from her. And then she released this one, the Battle Chinchilla. And this is so, so pretty. It also came packaged so beautifully. It is a nice weighty packaging and I think the pans are magnetic. It is magnetic. It is cardboard palette, no mirror, that I don't mind at all. It comes in two sizes actually. So I bought the regular size, but there's also a micro size. And that is just so freakishly cute, you know? Just the swatches I did not really build up. The dark purple swatches a little bit weirdly, but it's also because I have hairs there. Tiny hairs, but still I have hairs there and I can kind of see that the shadow wants to stick around the hairs. The shade names are on the back, but it is in Russian. The shades don't really have names, they have numbers. And what she also sent me was three of her pigments. It came with a card that I kind of misplaced. The shade names are on here, but they are all in Russian. So yeah, I don't know. But they are very, very pretty. They came in a tiny cardboard box and this is how the components are. So they're very small. Let me show you the colors. So this is a bluey one and it appears to have kind of a greenish shift. Very, very pretty. And then the next one is more along the lines of a purple. So I did swatch this one wet because it is almost impossible to pick up with the thing. And these kind of pigments I use wet. So with a wet brush, or in this case a wet finger. And then this is the last one, which is very, very interesting. Ooh, that one will be very pretty as a highlight if you have a deeper skin tone. I hope that you can see them though. I don't know if I will use these today. They do complement the palette very nicely, or at least I think so. When I look at the swatches side by side, yeah, especially these two. And then this one is a funky pop of something extra. Yeah, very, very pretty. So I'm going to play. I don't really know what I want to do. I kind of want to try and use everything. But let's just start because we are quite some time in and I haven't plopped any eyeshadow on my eyes. So let me get my brushes. So I have three mattes and they are all a little bit more cool toned. I really love the gray. Shall I just do the gray and then darken up with the purple and then that pinky one? Maybe on the bottom? Something like that. Now I have never worked with her eyeshadows before, so I'm very, very curious. Let me grab some brushes that I want to use. My base is still sticky. I'm using the one from Catrice again. But I think I'm going to try this one as a shimmer primer as well. Because it is so sticky and waterproof. And it is shitty weather. So I'm kind of curious to see how it will hold up. I'm going to go to the gray shade. Which is number 39. This one. And now I'm almost sad that I didn't get her neutrally palette as well. Now I saw Amy Loves Makeup use the neutral palette. because she had ordered that one as well, and it looked so, so pretty. And then when this one launched, I went on the site and I ordered it straight away, but I failed to kind of really check, you know, because she had also restocked that that other one, the dragon one. So yeah, I would have loved to own them both. Now, as I'm filming this, I saw a post on Instagram that she is coming out with more palettes, bigger ones. So yeah, I ordered this. What is happening there? I don't know. When did I order this? I ordered it on launch, and I don't remember exactly when it launched. I'll put it on the screen. And I received it last week, I believe. From Russia to me. Now, I was kind of expecting it to take longer, because we are having an... I think it is... What did they call it? An embargo? I don't know. Basically, apparently our government is pissed off with the Russian government because of stuff. And there's an embargo. So I was kind of expecting everything to take a very, very long time. But it really did not. Yeah, it took a few weeks, but I was expecting months. So, go to you. I'm going to go to this one because I changed my mind again. It's going to go lower. And then below that is probably going to go the darkest of the purple. So I'm not swirling my brush in, I'm just dabbing it in. And I'm tapping it on because I can feel that my base is still sticky and that the shadows stick to it very, very well. And to kind of help combat patchiness, I'm pressing it on and I will blend it out a little bit later, or at least I hope so. Now, there is a whole story involved in the shadows of this palette. It is on her site. And basically it's the evolution. It's on this card as well. So it's the evolution of the Battle Chinchilla. So the egg is purple, hence the purple. And then every shade basically has a story. I have no idea what it says here because I don't speak Russian. Well, I speak, I think, 3 words or something like that. So, yeah. And, you know, on the one hand, I wish that she would put her shade names in English as well. And on the other hand, I don't know, it is kind of that extra mystery, you know. I would love to, well, basically know, for instance, from the loose pigments, you know, I would love to have just a tiny sticker here on the bottom that says the English shade. Because I have no idea. On the other hand, I could kind of look it up, I think. Then I can put it on the sticker and just put it on the bottom. Maybe I will do that. And you know what I find? I'm going to go back to the first brush and then the gray shade again. Apparently I'm also a little bit chatty today. I'm going to blend the edges. I remember when I started with my makeup journey, which isn't that long ago. Basically, it is around the time that I started my channel, a little bit before that. So it is, I don't know, 3 or 4 years or something like that. And everyone and their mother on the internet said that because I was older, I should stick to neutrals. So I stuck to neutrals because I thought, yeah, okay, fine. These are my kind of neutrals though. This is the shadows that I gravitate towards then, so pinks and... but also smoky eyes. I didn't know how to do a smoky eye. It looked like it truly looked like Uncle Fester makeup, you know. But still, I tried. And then I discovered channels that promoted basically colorful makeup, and I was hooked. And I started with I wanted a red look and I wanted a yellow look, and for me those were colors. So that is how I started, and I have mentioned this before, but also in that period, I felt like because I kind of wanted to be different, you know, and I hate it when people are trying to push me in a box and I allow that, because you need to allow people to push you in a box for you to be in the box. I felt like I had to hate neutrals, but actually I don't. I do really, really like neutrals, but I like specific kinds of neutrals and specific looks and all that. So now that I am allowing myself to love all the colors of the spectrum, I kind of want her neutral palette too. I think that was the gist of it. I'm going to go to the darkest purple. And these are very gray leaning, which I don't mind at all. I don't know how these fare on a deeper complexion though. Just because they are so gray, you know, maybe they will turn ashy, I don't know. I do know that her Neutrally palette is more warm toned. Or at least I think so. I will leave Amy's video down below. I think she tried this palette as well, by the way. Okay, I'm going to go back to the previous brush and the previous shade, which was basically that lavender. Or maybe this is a lavender and the other one is a little bit more pinky, I don't know. I'm almost kind of sad that I put that pinkier shade in between. So I'm actually going to go back to the gray, the lightest gray, first shade, and I'm just going to blend over that pinkier one. I'm going to leave the pinkier one for the bottom or something like that. I don't know. Let's go over everything. I need a different brush. I have a clean brush here. Then I'm going to go, not with you. Yes, I want you, but I want you in the... I'm going to go to the darkest shade with a slightly bigger brush. I do like the fact that even though the middle one is more pink leaning, or at least on my skin tone, I can deepen it up with the shade that I'm working with now, but I just should not have used that gray shade then. Or at least that is how I like it, you know? Okay, I'm going to go back to that gray. And then the darkest purple. And I'm almost creating a wing shape with the eyeshadow. Almost, I am creating a wing shape with the eyeshadow. Basically, I'm just following my eyelid up, my bottom eyelid up, and then I'm connecting it visually to my, I don't know, to there. And then I'm just painting, and I'm basically ignoring everything. I'm just painting the shape, and then I'm filling it in. And what I'm doing then is making sure that it looks nice when I look down. And then I'm looking forward again. Okay, then I'm going to blend again with a darker shade just there where I put it. And then dragging it forward a tiny bit so that it flows nicely in the crease. Let's grab... let's grab this brush. I'm going to go to this gorgeous, gorgeous shade. I want this all over the lid. And I'm actually not going to use a glitter glue. However, I am kind of going to cut my crease. I'm going to grab my primer and put a little bit on the back of my hand. And then I'm going to take a brush and... I'm basically going to do the same thing as I would with my glitter primer, but the reason I'm doing this is because I kind of want to test it out. That is the reason. And because this stays sticky for such a long time, I think I can use it as a glitter primer as well. And the NYX glitter primer for me, while I love it, is not waterproof. Because when we are having shitty weather like we are having now, it still creases, but that is more along the lines of the way that my eyelids are. So I'm very curious to see how this behaves, because it is just as sticky as the NYX primer. Okay, then I'm going to go to that gorgeous shade. Oh, let's start here. Oh, it's so pretty. Let's go to that gray shimmer. Oh, no, the gray shimmer next to this one. and put that a little bit more in the outer corner. Maybe I'm going to combine it with that purpley one. Oh, very pretty. And this also has a shift. And then one side, that shade, the other side, the other shade that I just used, so I can kind of mix them together a bit. So basically to get them to sparkle, I don't need that glitter glue. I'm using it dry and I have no fallout on the face. But it's also, I think it sticks really, really well to that eyeshadow primer. Okay, I am going to go to the purple shimmer as well. Ah, it is more cool tone than I thought it would be. That's good. Me likey. What do I want for the bottom? Shall I do... I think I have basically a bluish... I think I want this one though. Yes, I just put the LA Girl Shockwave Neon Liner in the shade Fresh in the Waterline to pick up on the minty shade of the shimmery goodness that I have going on. Then I'm going to go with the darkest purple matte. Just extra. And then I'm cleaning my brush and I'm going to go into the darkest shimmer purple. It's going to go on top. And now I do have fallout, but it's very minimum. They stick very, very well where I place them. Now I do have a bit of primer here, but it has set already. But they do stick very, very nicely on their own. Okay. I also want the shade that I have there. I want there. I'm putting the gray, I don't know, that silvery gray shimmer in the inner corner. And I think that's fun. So this is it so far. I'm going to finish everything off. And then I will be back and give you my thoughts on the Battle Chinchilla. Everything is on. Here is the completed look. Falses are from Primark still, because I still have some. And the lippy is from Carity. It's one of their mattes in the shade Whatever. And it complements this look very nicely, or at least I think so. So let's go over what I used today. I didn't use the loose pigments. I will. It is though, for me, I have found that a lot of the time loose pigments are... loose pigments. I haven't had any that were very, very difficult to work with. The only thing though is go in with a wet brush. So basically have some water at hand, or I don't know, setting spray, and then spray your brush and then dip your brush in, tap it off a little bit and then apply it on your eye. That is usually how I work with loose pigments. If they are mattes or shimmers, it does not really matter, just because there is no binder in them. Does that make sense? But the colors are gorgeous and I cannot wait to play with these. Just, yeah, they weren't in this video. Let's go to the Battle Chinchilla palette. I love the fact that it is cool toned. The only thing though for me is that this shade pulls a little bit more pink. When I look at it in the pan, it is very cool tone, but it pulls very pink on my eyes. Now I can make it work and I like it. It's just that for me, I find that while I love the way that this look turned out, especially with the lippy, because that pulls that warmer shade a little bit more together, you know. For me, if I were to create, I don't know, a warmer toned look with this, I would start with this one. This would be my transition shade. I would deepen it up with this and I would put this one on the lid, for instance. But because I started with the gray, I kind of felt like this pulled a little bit too pink on me. But that is me. That is just the color selection, and that's basically because I wanted to cram all the shades on my eyes. I do think they are very nice to work with. They are a little bit sticky, or at least they stuck very, very well to my eyeshadow primer, which is also a little bit sticky. They are harder pressed in the pan. However, they are the right amount of pressed. And I hope that makes sense. So basically when you, I tap my brush in and I get pigment out of it, you saw, but it is not that I have instant whoosh of stuff in my palette. You know, so I can get pigment out, but I don't have a lot of kick up in the pan. That is what I wanted to say. The shimmers are gorgeous and they work very, very well with the shades that are in here. This shade for me, it's just magical. Overall, I do think that this palette is gorgeous and I love the quality and I cannot wait to play with it more. I also love the fact that it is nice and sleek and I don't know, it's just, it feels high-end, you know? So yeah, that is going to be my thoughts on this palette. Let me know down below if you have it. If you want it, I will link where you can find it. Because if you don't know where to navigate on her site, you cannot find this. I kind of, obviously I found it, so I will link it down below for you guys. And then that is going to be it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. A special thank you to my members that you will see scrolling on the screen. If you want to become a member, there's a link in the description box. And you can see all the information there. Yes, before you leave, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button if you liked it. And if you want to see more of me, just make sure that big red button isn't red anymore. And then that is it. Thank you so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye guys.